We've already learned about the chain rule in reverse. That technique was U-substitution, right? I want to anti-differentiate a function evaluated at g times the derivative of g. Well, I can make a substitution and reduce that just down to anti-differentiating f of this new variable u. Now we're going to run the product rule in reverse. Well, what is the product rule? Well, the product rule tells us how to differentiate a product of two functions. So here's two functions, f and g, and if I want to differentiate their product using the product rule, right, the derivative of their product is the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. Now integrate both sides. So then I get that the antiderivative of the derivative of f times g is antiderivative of, well, what's this by the product rule, right? It's the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. But the antiderivative of the derivative is just the original function. So let's write that down. That tells me that an antiderivative of the derivative of f times g plus f times the derivative of g is this, which is just f of x times g of x, and I'll include a constant. That's the integral of a sum, so it's the sum of the integrals. So integrate f prime of x g of x dx plus the integral of f of x g prime of x dx, and we get f of x times g of x plus a constant. And that's one very symmetric way of writing down the product rule in reverse. But we can rearrange it a bit more. I'll subtract this integral from both sides. So the left-hand side is just this integral. So the integral of f of x g prime of x dx is equal to, well, here's what we got on the right-hand side, f of x times g of x. But I'm going to subtract this, subtracting f prime of x g of x dx. Now look at what this is saying. It's saying that I can do this integration problem if I can do this integration problem. And how do these two integration problems differ? Well, here I've got a function times a derivative, and here I've got the derivative of f and an antiderivative of this, right? G is an antiderivative of g prime. So I can replace this integration problem with another integration problem where I've differentiated part of the integrand and anti-differentiated another piece of the integrand. It'll be a bit easier to see what's going on if I make some substitutions. Let's set u equal to f of x and dv equal to g prime x dx. And in that case, du is f prime x dx. And what's an antiderivative of this? Well, one of them is just g of x. So I can use these substitutions to rewrite what I've got up here. This integral is u times dv, and it's equal to u times v minus the integral of g is v, and f prime dx is du. So now I've got the integral of u dv is uv minus the integral of v du. This is maybe why it makes sense to call this integration by parts. So I can integrate u dv provided I can integrate v du. It's this trading game. I'm trading this integration problem for this integration problem, but now one part is differentiated and another part of the integrand is anti-differentiated. Maybe that'll make things better. With u substitution, we had to come up with a single u. In contrast, when you're doing integration by parts, when you're using this formula, you not only have to pick a u, but you've got to pick a dv so that you can write your integrand as u dv. This makes parts a bit harder to apply than u substitution. I've got to find both a u and a dv. But anytime you're willing to differentiate part of the integrand at the price of anti-differentiating the other part of the integrand, well, if that's something you're willing to do, parts will do that for you.